Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Chennappa. So in this video we are going to see about VFD speed control by digital inputs. Okay, so last video we have seen how we can do and control the VFDs by two wire controls and three wire controls. Okay, so in this video we will see the controlling of VFD speed by digital inputs. So we'll see in this video. Okay, so this VFD, there are many methods available for controlling the VFD speed, but by enable and disable the digital inputs which is available inbuilt with the VFD, this is the one of the most common and the easiest way, okay, to control the VFDs. Now we will see how we can do the speed control of the VFD by using the digital inputs. So for example, we have taken Schneider Altiva 212 VFDs. Okay, so I already told you the VFDs is common by operation. Even the design wise also little bit common only. Okay, so only the name mentioned on the VFDs in data sheet will be little different. So we have to refer as per the data sheets. Okay, so this is Schneider Altiva 212 VFD. Okay, so this is the, I think this is most common VFDs used around the globe. Okay, so I have selected these VFDs. Okay, now for enabling for control the VFD speed, we need at least four digital inputs. So one input will be for enable the start command of the VFD. So for enabling one digital input, we can give start command to the VFD. So other three we can give we can enable the digital inputs to control the speed of the VFD, or we can use the digital inputs to give the speed reference to the VFD. Okay, now we will see basic wiring, how we can do the wiring for control the VFD, speed up the VFD by using digital inputs. So we will take 24 volt. First we will connect start command. Okay, so this start command through any external relay or any on off switch. So this is start command. So now we have connected the start command input to the forward. Okay, now we will connect digital input 1. This is digital input 1 to reverse. Another we will connect digital input 2. Now we will connect digital input 3. So now we have connected forward start command, reverse as a digital input 1, reset input as a digital input 2, and VAA. So in this Schneider VFD, analog input also we can assign as a digital input. So now I have used the VAA, okay, one of the So one of the analog input I have considered digital input. Okay, so this is digital input 3. So this how we have to make wiring. So the start command we can give through any external relay or switch. Same digital input 1, 2, 3 we can enable and disable through a switch, also from any external relays or any external DC, SCADA or whatever, even limit switches we can use it. Okay, so after making this wiring, we have to do the settings in VFDs. So this is sample wiring diagram as shown in video. It's mentioned at the data sheet. Okay, so here, so we have given forward input, reverse input, reset input, and the analog input we have considered digital input. So each input there is a parameter number. So each parameter we can go and we can set the that particular input
configuration. Okay, so here for forward input F111, for reverse input F112, for RES input 113, for VAA selection F118, all mentioned in page number 100. Okay, each input has 0 to 73 options. Okay, so each number has some options. So we'll see one by one. So F111 we need forward. Okay, for F111 we need forward. You can put even 1 or 2. Okay, if input in enables, if it is set in 1 or 2, it will run in forward. Okay, even you can run even reverse also, so it's up to you. Then if reverse selection, we need digital input 1, okay, or preset input 1 here. So you can go 6, preset speed command input 1. The next input you can set 7, preset speed command input 2. The third VAA input you can set preset speed command input 3. Okay, so here I have shown you, if all together 000, so nothing. If it is only one input is enabled, preset speed 1. Up to 7 speed reference we can give to VFD to control the speed of the motor. So this is for only the Schneider VFD. If you are using any other brand VFD, so you have to refer that data sheet.
So forward input we have to consider as a start command. Reverse input we have to consider as a digital input 1 for multi-speed reference. Reverse digital input 2 for multi-speed reference. This analog input for VAA we have to consider digital input 3 for multi-speed command. Okay, so we have to assign the parameters accordingly. So after making this setting, you can give the start command. Okay, first you have to start. If you enable the start, then only VFD will be ready for the running. Once you start, after each digital input we can assign a speed. Okay, example, now digital input 1, if digital input 1 enables, speed 1, so there we can assign any percentage of the speed, 5% or 5 frequency, 10 frequency, whatever. Okay, so here we can give certain percentage of the speed, 5 example. Digital input 2, speed reference 2, this certain amount of speed we can set. Digital input 3, speed reference 3, so we can give some speed reference. Okay, so we have only 3 digital input. Out of 3 digital input we can give 7 speed reference. Like after finishing digital input 1 only enable, that will go to certain speed reference as per our setting. If digital input 2 only enables, it will go to certain speed up speed reference. Digital input 3, that will go to certain percentage of speed. So if you want another speed, then we have to enable digital input 1 and digital input 2. So this is speed reference 4. So this and all we can change. Okay, even with the digital input 1 enables, you can give full speed also or 50 half speed also. That we can set as per our requirement. Okay, so after, if digital input 2 and digital input 3 enables, speed reference 5, so that we can put some speed reference. And digital input 2 and digital input, sorry, digital input 1 and digital input 3 enables together, speed reference something we can put. Okay, if all the digital inputs enable, 1 and 2 and 3, this is some speed we can give. Okay, so with 3 digital inputs we can assign 7 multiple speed reference. Okay, so as I explained, we have to use 4 inputs. Okay, so 1 input will be for enable the start command. another 3 means rest 3 we can use to run the VFD in 7 different speed. Okay, as I mentioned, if digital input 1 only enables, we can use certain speed. If digital one input 2 only enables, it can be run, or we can give any speed reference to in particular value. If digital input 3 only enables, we can give some speed reference. Same digital input 1 and 2, some speed reference. Digital input 2 and 3, we can give some speed reference. Digital input 1 and 3, we can give some speed reference. All together, if you enable, we can give some speed reference. So we can run up to 7 speeds by digital inputs. Okay. So this is the easiest way, also the best way to control the VFD speed in multiple. This is the most common method used for controlling the VFDs, especially in industrial application as well as in HVAC. In industrial, this method is used to control the speed of the conveyor as well as the power hoist or any hoppers. Okay, by using limit switches, we can enable and disable the digital inputs to the VFD, and we can control the VFD. We can control the motors through this VFD. In HVAC system, you can control this AHO motors by enable disabling this digital inputs. Okay, so I hope you understood the way I explained. So in your future projects, you can easily control your VFD speed by using digital inputs. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you are first time watching my channel, please do subscribe. If you like my video, also do the subscribe. Okay, so I will meet you in next video. Till then, bye from Sennappa. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay, thanks.